Blessings and love. It is always a great day here at Refuge and Fortress. My name is Emmanuel O.
And I'm Loni O.
So as you guys already know, this entire month, we wanted to talk about finance and relationship. Yeah. Our goal is to help you grow your faith and win in relationships, right? Yes. So we want to talk today about how to handle financial challenges. Well, there has been a pandemic since last year, yeah, right? And this has been going on for a while. There are some people that has been affected badly since last year by COVID, and we're not oblivious to that fact at all, you know? And we can understand there are, you know, it's understandable how finance or change in finance in a negative way can affect a relationship or a marriage or whatever the case may be. So today we just want to offer five tips on how to handle financial challenges when that time comes. You see, there will always be time in a man's life, a woman's life, a relationship, a marriage, where you're going to have to face some challenges, sometimes some financial challenges, and it could take you aback if you're not prepared for it. Yeah. And so we hope that today, the tip we're going to share today will really help you. It will be practical for you to apply right now to get better in your relationship.
So the first tip on how to handle financial challenges is open communication.
Absolutely.
We're talking about being there for each other. Mm-hmm. That's the first thing, because sometimes you're faced with situations where one person loses their job, both of them lose their job, and now you got to figure out how to navigate things. Mm-hmm. How do you pay for this and pay for that and pay for this? And it can be a lot on a person.
Yes.
But that's why you're there together. Mm-hmm. You know, God made woman to be an helpmate to the man.
Yeah.
So the man is not alone. So the woman is not alone. You're there to help each other.
Yes.
So you be there for each other. You communicate.
Absolutely.
Talk about how you feel. Talk about what's going on. Mm-hmm. Try to figure out how to get out of the situation.
Right.
Try to be there for each other.
Absolutely.
Lean on each other, so you're not alone in the thought process,
right? Absolutely.
Especially for men, because they tend to take on that weight and tend to bottle it in.
Yes.
And but that's why you have your helpmate there, so that way, even if it's just letting it out, you have somebody there to be able to bounce some thoughts and some situations to.
Absolutely. I think the bottom line on that is just to table it, right?
Yeah.
It's happened. What do we do now?
Exactly.
Let's come together. Let's have a conversation. Let's talk about it. Let's face it, right? Mm-hmm. There's no need to have an elephant in the room.
Right.
There is no elephant in the room.
Yeah.
It happened. Life happened, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's table it.
Let's talk about it.
Let's be open about it. And then come together and strategize on what to do moving forward.
Right. Get another job. You know, just figure out what. There's so many other solutions.
Yep.
Just figure out how to
absolutely
move forward.
How to move forward. Open communication.
Yes.
Tabling it and discussing, strategizing how to move forward.
Absolutely.
Number two, the second thing that you can immediately do is cut down on some expenses. Like, we don't need that Netflix subscription anymore. We don't need that gym subscription anymore. If you want to work out, go outside and walk outside.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Take
a jog or something.
We don't need,
there's a lot of things we don't need. Hey, that kid in Africa that you're sponsoring,
you can take a pause.
He gonna have to understand.
I'm
playing. But
it's
no, for real though, if you cannot sponsor anyone else, you know, take a pause
friends,
on that, right?
Family.
Friends, family, just cut down on some expenses as much as you possibly can and do it graciously.
Mm-hmm.
Do it joyfully.
Yeah.
Do it together. There's no need for any one of you guys to make it hard on the other, right? So let's say, for example, if we're sponsoring somebody from the wife's family or somebody from the husband's family, and one of them are going to have to understand why we can't do that anymore.
Absolutely.
The wife shouldn't make it a burden or a difficult situation for the man and say, well, you know, we've always supported my family for so long, we can't just stop now.
Well,
you know,
or the support me.
You know what I'm saying? Or the man shouldn't go, well, you know, this is something we've always had to do, we can't just stop supporting them now.
Right.
No. Together, we can come together and make a decision and say, you know what? For now, we're not going to sponsor anyone anymore.
Yeah.
Until we're able to get back on our feet. Just cut down on all unnecessary expenses.
You know, downsize in a lot of things that you have to do.
Mm-hmm.
Try to just figure out ways to just save up more money.
Yep.
spending the time that you're able to kind of figure out how to get back on your feet.
The date nights, you can reduce it now.
You can do it yourself at home, date night. There's so many ways around it. Cook more,
don't eat out as much. Like, there's so many ways you can do. But the bottom line is you're doing it together. You're doing it graciously without making it hard and difficult for each other. That's where we avoid the tears, the late night crying, the depression, the stress, the frustration. The tensions, exactly.
It doesn't help at all. So the third tip is watch your emotions.
Yes.
This goes back to what we've talked about in the first two tips.
Yeah.
Watch your emotions. You know, life happens, things happen, and little things can trigger or affect us.
Yes.
But we have to make sure that we don't let these things affect this.
Right.
You don't let it affect your relationship.
Right.
Because at the end of the day, it just makes things worse. Mm-hmm. It doesn't help the situation. Mm-hmm. You know, don't let the frustrations break this up. Don't let the frustrations affect your relationship.
Your union.
Because at the end of the day, that is very, very important. That's gonna last.
Yes.
That's always gonna be there.
Mm-hmm.
So always figure out how to fix everything else and make sure that you and your significant other are good and on the same page.
Right. When we say watch your emotions, really what we're saying is this, right? So we've talked about it. We're cool. We're on the same page. But there's just some days, you know, you step out, you come back inside.
You're frustrated.
For whatever reason, something happened outside. Somebody said something you didn't like. You come home. Don't project that frustration and emotion onto your family.
Exactly.
You know, park it outside. Mm-hmm. Just watch your emotions. Don't let what's going on cause you to begin to talk ill about your wife, your husband, your children, or begin to act a certain way and not be as loving as you used to anymore and stuff like that. Like, you should be able to maintain the same emotion when you had money and now that you don't.
Yes,
really, because what we're saying is this: your joy, your happiness is not tied, should not be tied to money.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know, it's not like, okay, so you're not working anymore. So there's no job anymore. So we got to figure this thing out.
Like
we're going through something. So does that mean that all of a sudden you're not the loving husband that I once knew anymore? Or you're not the supportive wife that I once knew anymore?
Exactly.
Like, nothing should change. We're just going to have to figure it out. But watch your emotions. Don't let what's going on right now get the best of you, especially when it comes to your family.
And we understand that sometimes people can control their emotions and they just react off of it.
Right.
But that's why it goes back to the communication.
Mm-hmm.
When you're talking to each other and you know your significant other is there for you,
mm-hmm.
you wouldn't feel the need to project your emotion or your anger or your frustration to your significant other. So just watch your emotions.
Right. And again, you know what? Just catch yourself. That's why the key word here is watch it, right?
Exactly.
It happens. And when it does, just be like, babe, you know, I'm sorry.
It's not you.
This whole thing is just, it has me in a whole different mind frame. Exactly. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to talk to you like that. I didn't mean to do this. I didn't mean to do that. Like, whatever the case, just watch it. You know what I'm saying? Just be watchful of it. Because when it does happen, you're able to catch yourself really quickly and say, okay, cool. And then again, for the other spouse in this scenario, for example, be graceful enough to allow room for when these things happen, right? So the man, I used the example of the man, went out, came back home, things didn't go the way he wanted to. He gets angry, he wants to project that on his family, right? What about the woman who's been home all day taking care of the kids? As the kids are like being all discombobulated and stuff, that could bring up some rough emotions that she also can project on you.
Exactly.
As the husband, you should have the grace to say, babe, you know what? I understand. You know what? And then sometimes just say, you know what? Drop everything. Let's take a walk. Right? Let's go outside.
Let's
go visit a family friend or something. Like, let's go do something to get our mind off the situation right now while we're trying to figure this thing out. You know?
Figure out ways to just leave that joy and happiness in it. Even in times that are tough, you find joy.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's
your joy, your happiness, your fulfillment is not tied to your money.
Yes.
Know that, okay? All right, and number four, the fourth tip that we have on how to deal with financial challenges is this: use it as an opportunity to rebrand yourself.
Yes.
It's an opportunity. Look, One door closes, another one opens, right? Rebrand yourself. What is the thing that you've always wanted to do? Is there a business you've always wanted to start? Is there a book you've always wanted to write? Did you want it to become a creator, right? Like, what is the opportunity that's always been out there that perhaps your job has been blocking you from getting done before?
Yeah.
Look at it like, I would say try to find positivity in every situation.
Absolutely.
Right? Yeah. Think about it. What is God trying to teach me in this moment right now with this financial challenge that we're going through? Mm-hmm. I've known people who lost their job, lost their business, lost all their contract, lost everything, and in a matter of a year became a millionaire. How do you explain that?
Yeah.
How do you explain it? Because they were able to rebrand themselves. They didn't give up. They didn't slouch. They didn't cave in. They didn't say, well, the word is over. Mm-hmm. The life is over. I don't know what I'm going to do. No, they used that opportunity to rebrand themselves.
Yeah.
Start a business, get a side gig, find another job, mm-hmm. whatever the case may be, you know, like look inside of yourself and figure out one thing that you can do and
or
do well, a passion, and offer that to the world.
Yeah.
You have the time now.
Absolutely. And we're in the day and age or the time where creativity is on high.
Yeah.
You know, you have that creative mindset or passion or talent, so to say, where look at what happened last year. COVID happened. Well, guess what? A lot of people came out millionaires out of that from being creative and just doing things. It might not even be something that you've dreamt about. Mm. You were just sitting down thinking, you know what, I could do this, did it, and boom, it worked.
Absolutely.
So you just have to just don't soak in the downtime.
Mm-hmm.
Wake up.
Yeah.
Try to figure out how to, you know, move forward and be creative.
Yeah, absolutely. And utilize what you have around you. You know, start where you are, where you're at with what you have.
Yeah.
Social media is great right now. If you're a great cook, cook that meal very well.
Record yourself,
put it up on social media.
Yeah.
You know, somebody's gonna notice and somebody's gonna solicit and want to enlist your offer, your service, right?
Yeah.
They want to, you know, they want your service. They want you to come in and cook. They want you to come in and cater for them. Whatever it is that you're really good at, put it up on there. It's social media is free.
Yeah.
It's free advertisement. You
the
know
internet,
what I'm saying?
Online.
You know, and that's the word we live
exactly.
in right now.
Exactly. We're living
rebrand,
in the word.
Rebranding
exactly.
yourself, you know.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
Yeah.
Then the final thing, the final way to handle financial challenges is pray. Oh man, listen.
Pray.
Go to God. Listen.
Yes.
In the good times, you pray. In the bad times, you pray.
Yes.
Always go to Him, because at the end of the day, He is the one that would see you through.
Yes.
He's the one that would open that next door.
Prayer is still the key.
You know, prayer is always the key.
Yep.
Go on your knees.
Mm-hmm.
Go in your secret place. Go in your private room and just go seek God's face and just help. Ask Him to help you.
Yeah.
Prayer works.
Yep.
Go pray. Go read your Bible.
Yep.
Go talk to God.
And join a community
yes.
that is faith-based, that will help you, uplift you, encourage you
Absolutely.
In times like this.
Yeah.
The Refuge and Fortress Network, for example, is a great organization to
Man,
be a part
I've
of.
I've heard so many
we
things
have,
about
we
them.
Have, we have prayers on Fridays that we do at midnight. We do. We have Bible discussions that we do on Thursdays. We meet once a month here in the DMV area, where we bask in the presence of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
We talk about different interactive discussions, different interactive activities.
Yeah.
We have discussions as it pertains to relationship, finance, culture, faith. You know, we do a lot of things to bring together the body of Christ.
Yes.
So we have different churches in the network, and you are more than welcome to be a part of that. You want to join a community that will help uplift you,
yes.
that will not leave you, that will help uplift you, a community of like-minded people
mm-hmm.
where we're going to push you and give you all the tools that you need
yes.
to become the best version
of
yourself.
Yes.
We preach three things: transformation, maximize potential, and kingdom living.
That's
how
it.
To live that life of
yes.
abundance, that full and well-lived life. You want to be a part of something great
Absolutely.
Like that, you know? And I think that's all we have for today.
I
think that's all we have for today. We hope we shared a tip or two to help solidify your kingdom union today.
Don't forget to like, to subscribe, to share, and to comment down below.
And as always, be the light.
Be the salt.
And remember,
all
things
are
possible
if you believe.